Hi, I'm Anshu Jasani with Divorce with Dignity. As we've come out of COVID, I'm starting to give out business cards. How long has it been since you gave out a business card? Probably didn't give out many in 2020. So I took a look at my business card and I found some really great information on the card. On the front, I have all my contact information, but on the back, I have 10 tips to more successful dispute resolutions. So whether you're a mediator looking at a client or someone just having a dispute and you want to have better dispute resolution, these tips can be helpful. So tip number one, define the problems to be addressed. So when you're in a conflict, oftentimes we're talking about the past, but we're not trying to change the past. We're trying to create a solution to a problem. So let's focus on that. The second is to focus on interests, not positions. People get locked into yes, no, binary thinking. But what are we really interested in? Is it interested in having a relationship with the person we're having a disagreement with? Is it raising healthy children? So let's focus on that and stop the yes, no. The third is to establish trust by keeping commitments. So for a parenting relationship, if your agreement temporarily is you're going to drop the children off at six, drop the children off at six. If the very first time after you've made an agreement, you start drop them off at nine, there's a very little lack of trust going forward. The next, number four, is to go hard on the problem, soft on the people. We don't have to be hit with a hammer to get our message across. In fact, being kinder is often better to our adversary. Number five is to invent multiple solutions for mutual gain. So rather than looking at one solution, look at multiple solutions, and then we can eliminate some and get to the one that's optimal. The sixth is to separate inventing from deciding. So in that process of putting options together, let's be creative, and then we can get to the solution stage. The next is to use objective criteria for decision making. So that we may want to look at what's usually done, or let's look at some numbers, or let's look at what an expert might say if we can't agree. But we don't have to use personal subjective criteria. Let's look at what's usually done. Number eight is to understand your cost and their cost of not reaching an agreement. What is stress doing to your life? What is it doing in terms of, you know, not being able to go out because you have to prepare court papers or you have to take time off from work? There's much more beyond the financial cost of not settling. Number nine is to identify tactics that undermine the negotiation process. For instance, one tactic is that once an offer is made, you accept it, but you kind of nibble away and ask for a little more. It's very hard to come to a resolution when it's a moving target. And the last, number 10, is to ensure that the agreements made are realistic. There's no use making an agreement that sounds very generous, but you can't achieve it. So coming up with realistic solutions is really optimal in dispute resolution. I hope these 10 tips have been helpful. It's Anshu Jasani for Divorce with Dignity Mediation Services, saving dollars, making sense.